Thunder Radio, where we groove as the spirit moves. Yeah. Drawing the honey from the rock with the righteous Reverend Doctor on Booming Thunder Radio.
Shalom, mighty friend and fellow Hanukkite warrior, lover of the truth. With each breath we take, in each step we make in this world, may heaven be in our hearts and on our lips, and bring the manna fast before all the willing vessels that are empty and wish to be filled, yea, with the hope of being filled everlasting. The glory of your Hoshua HaMashiach in each of our hearts, yea. The Hanukkite warrior way of truth and justice. I've seen some of these madmen, soldier conjuring type of videos out there, portraying the warriors of God as some bloodthirsty savage that's going to go and kill all the evil in the earth for the justice of God. Well, I'm here to tell you, mighty friend, that is all madness. I don't believe it, because what does it say, the Yehoshua HaMashiach worked and moved and breathed and stepped in the earth in that way? Not once do you ever hear that an iron sword was in his hand. He only had a parable word, and he laid his sword upon, yea, the decks of captains of old, that stand, yea, as reapers, and we stand with them, joining into the work of Yehoshua HaMashiach. Yea, mighty friend. Wisdom parted her pages before us today at 1191. Our brother Thea is before us on his knees, bowing to the God of Israel, as we have bowed before him this very day. Hallelujah, Hoshua HaMashiach. In the Greek 1191, for the Thea definition, as the blade is laid upon his chest of treasure, the wisdom and the knowledge of everlasting glory in the earth. Thea's definition of derby is a tanner of skin, a coverer with skin. Now, if you had the coat of many colors as Joseph had, and were despised by his brothers, sold into slavery, and yet God blessed him, and all the wisdom of Egypt was given him, And so his coat of many colors became a cloak of black goat hair. Our brother Thea looks up at us with his double portion on his shoulder, and he has no peace, mighty friend. The only peace he has is when he causes strife in another man's life. He lays his guilt upon another man's head. But there is one that, and only one that can cover that black goat hair, and that's the white lamb skin. Yea, and our father says that in order to raise the tabernacle, yea, to stand at the gap in the opening, yea, before the tabernacle door, the tent of meeting, we must die as Yehoshua HaMashiach died, and take his blood as we have taken his blood in our heart and place it upon the lambskin and dye it, removing it, placing it over the black goat hair. And then, mighty friend, that last covering is the prayer shawl. It looks like a honey badger skin. It goes over the top of all of it. And if any would come in its burrow or to steal or kill or destroy its family or food, it will devour them until they are no longer in the earth. But not with a metal blade, but by the everlasting glory by each one's side. Yea, the covering, yea, of the foreskin circumcised in your heart, that the four skins could be thrown upon the fire inside, washed by the laver, by the washing of the word, received in the fourth watch. Yea, let us share before the early the listening reflection of truth is blinding the world of the day and of the night. So let us move and see what the complete word study has for us on G1191. It's a city, Derby, a city in Lacedonia. It's about 20 miles from Lystra. In 1420, Acts 1420, but while the disciples stood around him, he got up and entered the city. The next day, he went away with Barnabas to, there it is, G1191, to Derby. Yeah, let us cross over, having gone the way with Barnabas and this Mashiach in our heart, crossing over into the Hebrew word study. Let us read 1 Kings 9:18 for Hebrew 11:91 in the complete word study. And Baaloth, there it is, Baal Auth. H1191. And Tamar in the wilderness in the land of Judah. How about this one? 2 Chronicles 8:6. And Baalath, there it is, right off the bat, H1191. And all the storage cities that Solomon had, and all the cities for his chariots, and cities for his horsemen, and all that it pleased Solomon to build in Jerusalem, in Lebanon, and in all the land under his rule. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Now what does the old brown driver have to say? Baalath is the Hebrew meaning of the word mistress. It's also a town in Dan. I wonder what... I know that they were... I'm certain that they were patterning their lives like Sodom and Gomorrah in the town of Dan named Mistress. Sad but true, my dear friend. So, now that we have prepared to go and take our sword and our bullfrog gig and go down there with our brother Micah to that old green water pond and see if we can find some big old bullfrogs like Jeremiah. Yeah, and them old toads that try to make out like they're Jeremiah. Yeah, let's go, Micah. Let's go gig 'em. Yeah. But before we go, let us hear the message at the temple gate. Yea, that we can stand before the opening of the tent of meeting and prepare what is required for the temple gate to swing open and shut and never open. The word, Jeremiah, chapter 7, verse 1. Do you have your word ready? Do you have your sword in your hands? A word of truth. That the word that came to Jeremiah from the existing father saying, stand in the gate of the existing one's house and proclaim there, yea, from your heart, this word and say, hear the word of the existing father and all you of Yehuda who enter by these gates to worship Yehoshua. Do you hear? Thus says the existing Father of hosts and the everlasting glory, which is the God of Israel in the earth. Amend your ways and your deeds, and I will let you dwell in this place. Yea, the true temple. Yea, first imagined in the tabernacle of your mind with the Father placing the building blocks upon your heart. Do not trust in deceptive words saying, this is the temple of the existing Father. The temple of the existing Father. The temple of the existing Father. For if you truly amend your ways and your deeds, mighty friend, you will truly practice justice between a man and his neighbor. If you do not oppress the alien, the orphan, or the widow, and do not shed innocent blood in this place, nor walk after other gods in your own ruin, then I will let you dwell in this place, in the land that I give to your fathers forever and ever, a place in your heart. Behold, you are trusting in deceptive words to no avail as you go in and out of the temple gate to worship, when inside your heart is a ravenous wolf. Will you steal, murder, and commit adultery, and swear falsely, and offer sacrifices to Baal, and walk after other gods that you have not known? Then come and stand before me in this house, which is called by my name, and say, "We are delivered," that you may do all these abominations. Has this house, which is called by my name, become a den of robbers in your sight? Behold, the eyes, even your eyes, have seen it, declares the existing Father. But go now to our place, which is in Shiloh, where I made my name dwell at the first, and see what I did to it because of the wickedness of the people Israel. And now, because you have done all these things, declares the existing Father, and I spoke to you, rising up early and speaking, but you did not hear, and I called you, but you did not answer. Therefore, I will do to the house which is called by my name, in which you trust, and to the place which I gave you and your fathers, as I did in Shiloh. I will cast you out of my sight, as I have cast out all your brothers, all the offspring of Ephraim. As for you, do not pray for this people, and do not lift up cry or prayer for them, and do not intercede with them, or us, for I do not hear you. Did you not see what they are doing in the cities of Yehuda and in the streets of Jerusalem? The children gather wood, and the fathers kindle the fire, and the women knead dough to make cakes for the Queen of Heaven, and they pour out drink offerings to other gods in order to spite the existing Father. Do they spite the everlasting glory in the earth? Declares the Spirit of Truth. Is it not themselves they spite to their own shame? Their ignorance of the word, their blindness sickens me. Strengthen each of us, Father, for we have all been a pagan in our life, that we can have the mercy to endure their blindness until they have come into the light and see your mighty hand in their heart, pulling back the temple door and drawing the veil before the ark once more. Therefore, thus says Yahushua HaMashiach, the everlasting glory, the spirit of truth in the earth. Behold, my anger and my wrath will be poured out on this place, on man and on beast, and on the trees of the field, and on the fruit of the ground, and it will burn and not be quenched. Thus says the existing Father of hosts, the God of Israel, add your burnt offerings to your sacrifices and eat flesh. For I do not speak to your fathers or command them in the day that I brought them out of the land of Egypt concerning burnt offerings and sacrifices. But this is what I commanded them, saying, obey my voice, and I will be your God, and you will be my people, and you will walk in all the way which I command you, that it may be well with you. Yet they did not obey or incline their ear, but walked in their own counsels and in their own stubbornness of their evil heart, and went backward and not forward. Since the day that your fathers came out of the land of Egypt until this very day, I have sent you all my servants, the prophets, daily rising early and sending them. Yet they did not listen to them or incline their ear, but stiffened their neck. They did more evil than their fathers ever even imagined. They shall speak all these words to them, but they will not listen to you. And you shall call to them, but they will not answer you. You shall say to them, this is the nation that did not obey the voice of Yahushua HaMashiach that reveals the Eternal One, or accept the correction. Yea, the truth has perished and has been cut off from their mouth. Cut off your hair and cast it away, and take up a lamentation on the bare heights. For the existing Father has rejected and forsaken the generation of his wrath. For the sons of Yehuda have done that which is evil in the sight, declares the existing Father. They have set their detestable things in the house which is called by my name to defile it. They have built the high places of Topath, which is in the valley of the son of Hinnom, to burn their sons and their daughters in the fire, which I did not command. And it did not come into my hand. Therefore, behold, days are coming, declares the existing Father, when it will no longer be called Topath or the valley of the son of Hinnom, but the valley of the slaughter, and they will bury in Topheth, because there is no other place. The dead bodies of this people will be food for the birds of the sky and for the beasts of the earth, and no one will frighten them away. Do you hear? When the eyes will make it to cease from the cities of Yehuda and from the streets of Jerusalem, the voice of joy and the voice of gladness, the voice of the bridegroom and the voice of the bride, for the land will become a ruin. Chapter 8. The Sin and Treachery of Yehuda. At that time, declares the existing father, they will bring out the bones of the kings of Yehuda, and the bones of its princes, and the bones of the priests, and the bones of the prophets, and the bones of the inhabitants of Jerusalem from their graves. They will spread them out to the sun, the moon, and to all the hosts of heaven, which they have loved, and which they have served, and which they have gone after, and which they have sought, and which they have worshipped. They have not been gathered or buried. They will be as dung on the face of the ground, and death will be chosen rather than life by all the remnant that remains on this evil family, that remains in all the places to which I have driven them, declares the existing Father of hosts. You shall say to them, thus says Yahushua HaMashiach's Father, Mariahovah, do men fall and not get up again? Do they stay down? Does one turn away and not repent? Why then has this people, Jerusalem, turned away in continual apostasy? They hold fast to deceit. They refuse to return. I have listened and heard. They have spoken what is not right. No man repented of his wickedness, saying, what have I done? Everyone turned to his course, like a horse charging into the battle. Even the stork in the sky knows her seasons, and the turtle dove and the swift and the thrush observe the time of their migration. But my people do not know the ordinance of the existing Father. So how can you say we are wise and the law of the existing Father is with us? But behold, the lying pen of the scribes has made it into a lie. Do you hear? The wise men are put to shame. They are dismayed and caught. Behold, they have rejected the word of the existing Father. And what kind of wisdom do they have? Therefore, I will give their wives to others, their fields to new owners, because from the least even to the greatest, everyone is greedy for gain, from the prophet even to the priest. Everyone practices deceit. They heal the brokenness of the daughter of my people superficially, saying, "Peace, peace," but there is no peace. No peace in their heart, their carnal mind. Can't even imagine the still water in our hearts. Were they ashamed because of the abominations they had done? They certainly were not ashamed, and they did not know how to blush. Therefore, they shall fall among those who fall. At the time of their punishment, they shall be brought down, says Yahushua HaMashiach's mighty Father, Yehovah. I will surely snatch them away, declares the existing Father. There will be no grapes on the vine, and no figs on the fig tree. And the leaf will wither, and what I have given them will pass away. Why are we sitting still? Assemble yourselves and let us go into the fortified cities, and let us perish there. Because the existing Father, our God, has doomed us and gave us poisoned water to drink, and we have sinned against the existing Father. We waited for peace, but no good came, for a time of healing, but behold, terror. From Dan is heard the snorting of his horses. At the sound of the neighing of his stallions, the whole land quakes, for they come and devour the land and its fullness, the city and its inhabitants. For behold, I am sending serpents against you, adders for which there is no charm, and they will bite you, declares the existing Father. My sorrow is beyond healing. My heart is faint within me. Behold, listen. The cry of the daughter of my people from a distant land. Is the existing Father not in Zion? Is her king not within her? Why have they provoked me with their graven images, with foreign idols? Harvest is past, summer is ended, and we are not saved. For the brokenness of the daughter of my people, I am broken. I mourn. Dismay has taken hold of me. Is there no balm in Gilead? Is there no physician there? Why then has not the health of my daughter and my people been restored? He repented, humbled, seeking first the kingdom and the righteousness of the everlasting glory in our hearts. Yea, mighty friend. you know what time it is. You got your covering on. You got your four skins wrapped around you. Are you ready to be circumcised in your heart? Because it's the heart is where the temple is built inside heavens in the earth for all those who return to the existing Father's house, which is not a carnal mind, but it is a awakened 94% of the spiritual mind of everlasting, which is seen and unseen in this world of Mystery Babylon. But not much longer, Mystery Babylon will be taken into the chambers of darkness, and all those that worship other gods will be imprisoned with them for 1,000 years. And the righteous will rule and reign and be taught the everlasting glory by the Mashiach and all his chosen vessels filled with his glory, yea, revealing the true Father, the Father of everlasting, the existing one, yea, Mare Yehovah. So when we go to HebrewPi.com, that's HebrewPi.com, and look for two faithful witnesses, and scroll down to that first big block of numbers there, and push on number 48, that'll take you to HebrewPi 48. Or you can just search HebrewPi 48 on Google, or DuckDuckGo, and bada bing, you are uniting the bride, is the title. And you see a multi-tiered staircase with, yea, could it be as we have seen from the cleft of the rock, with our backs up against the wall, and the Father's hand covering us as he passes by, and all we see is his backside. Yea. And the image, yea, that is beyond understanding, the white linen and how long is your, yea, how high is the split of your dress? How many steps does your whiteness cover? Can you stand in the middle by the old oak tree? Yea, so the sum of Hebrew Pi 48 is 2, 2, 2. And as we go and we look at the Brown Driver Briggs, for the Hebrew 2, 2, 2, we see that the BDB definition is Uriel, God, El is my light. Hallelujah, I could not agree more. God is my light. That is what Uriel means in Hebrew. A chief of the Levitical line of Kohath, in David's time, the beloved King David, maternal grandfather of Abijah also. Now, If we take a look at the complete word study, it talks about a name of a Levite, another Levite under David and the grandfather of Abijah. 2 Chronicles 13:2. He reigned 3 years in Jerusalem, and his mother's name was Micaiah, the daughter of Uriel. There it is, H222. Of Uriel of Gibeth. Now there was war between Abijah and Jeroboam. Now, those who fell back, having once tasted the glory, but turning back to the Greek mindset, we see that G222 is one that belongs to Alexandria, but not necessarily born or living there. It's also spoken of a ship. And the Thea definition, a native or resident of Alexandria in Egypt. Yea, they went back, like all those murmuring ones with Moses that died in their murmuring 40 years in the desert, letting all the evil die off so that the new wineskin with the truth could come forth and forgive all that has remained and begin again to build the temple in each of our hearts, with the wise master builder revealed in the tabernacle of our minds. Are you ready for Hebrew Pi 48, mighty friend?
Uniting the bride. Reveal the basket. Set it before our eyes. Fill it with your abundance in the tabernacle of the mind. Let us gather the liquid light and drink it deep within. Let the veils covering the mysteries be illuminated, allowing us to hear Yahuwah yet again. Let the breath of the Ruach pass through the veil. Surround us with goodness and mercy of our mighty Hashem. Yahuwah grants us repentance, uniting the bride with his son, a marriage made in heaven to last for the rest of time. An apostolic life rewarded to those that find the door, those that are the bride, righteous ones with trains of white glowing with completeness forevermore. Take in the seed, walk with him, let the Ruach of God radiate from deep within.
Friend. Have you listened to the Elijah ministry teaching? Yeah, Petro.
Just an old-fashioned love song playing on the radio. And wrapped around the music is the sound of someone promising they'll never go.
Never go.